Thanks for tuning in. This is The Life of a Miner, and let's check out week 55 of my mining payouts. Okay, so at the beginning of these payout videos, let's do a quick spot check of the date and time. Today is March 29th of 2020, and it's about 6 p.m. U.S. Eastern Time. So like previous weeks, I've been mining Ethereum, and I do average around 231 mega hashes. Now, I did turn some of my AMD mining rigs off because it's actually not profitable to mine with those as of today, but of course that could change down the road. I've been also mining Grimcoin, and I do average around 156 grass per second. And last but not least, I've been mining Monero, and I do average around 15 kilohashes. Now pulling up my Excel and checking out what I mined. Now this is about a 20-day payout. I did mine around 0.83 Ethereum, equaling around $106.78, about 644.1 Grincoin, equaling around $283.44, and about 0.14 Monero, equaling around $6.49. So if I did sell everything as of today, I would have made $396.71. Okay, so now checking out my electricity bill. I do pay about 10 cents per kilowatt hours, and for this month, my electricity bill did come out to be about $406. Okay, so now pulling back on my Excel, and if I did sell weekly, I would have made $646.84. My first mining farm, the electricity bill came out to be that $406. My second mining farm is a set fee of $100, so my total electricity cost came out to be $506. So my total profit for this month came out to be $140.84. Now, I do want to mention that the month of March isn't over and I still have two more days, so technically my profits should be a little bit higher. I've just been really busy, so I'm just trying to get these videos out. And the price of crypto did drastically drop, so it's actually not a good time to sell, but a great time to buy. Okay, so now checking out my GPU count. I do have a total of 86 GPUs and 1 CPU. Now, my GPUs are mining Ethereum and Grincoin, and I do have my CPU mining Monero. Now, I do have some of my AMD mining rigs off because it's not profitable, and of course, I do have two mining farms. Alright, so for this week's fun clip, this is a clip from 60 Minutes, and since I work in the finance industry and we just keep printing money, this is one of the main reasons we need Bitcoin. So let's check this out.
Millions of people are going to lose their jobs, and that's what's so scary about this.
Are we in a recession?
If we're not right now, we will be soon. My base case scenario is we will at least have a mild recession, like after 9/11. The worst case would be we'd have a deep recession like the 2008 financial crisis. We just don't know right now.
And what's keeping us from knowing with any certainty?
Nobody knows how the virus is going to progress, how many Americans are going to get it, how effective is social distancing going to be, how long will it take the healthcare system to catch up.
Nationwide last week, there were almost 300,000 people filing first claims for unemployment benefits.
It could be five times that amount next week, maybe more.
Where is the bottom?
If this is a three-month shutdown, we'll find the bottom pretty soon. If this is a year-long shutdown, this could be very damaging to the U.S. economy and, most importantly, to the American people.
Will the Federal Reserve ensure that banks have all the cash they need to satisfy whatever withdrawals may be coming?
Yes. This is the fundamental reason the Federal Reserve exists. We call it lender of last resort. This is literally why central banks exist. If everybody gets scared at the same time and they demand their money back, that's why the Federal Reserve is here, is to make sure that there's liquidity, that there's money to meet those demands. We will absolutely meet those demands.
Is the Fed just going to print money?
That's literally what Congress has told us to do. That's the authority that they've given us, to print money and provide liquidity into the financial system. And that's how we do it. We create it electronically, and then we can also print it with the Treasury Department, print it so that you can get money out of your ATM. But there's a range of things that the Federal Reserve could do. We're far from out of ammunition.
Far from out of ammunition. Sunday, the Federal Reserve lowered its benchmark interest rate to zero. Can you go below zero?
In theory, we could. Some countries have. I don't think any of us on the committee think that's a particularly good idea. It creates other challenges for financial markets. But in the last crisis, we used something called quantitative easing, buying long-term bonds. We've got a lot more experience in how to do that. It didn't trigger inflation. So there are other tools that we've used before that I think we could also use again and use again aggressively.
To the person who is about to grab their car keys and go to the ATM and take out $3,000, you say what?
You don't need to. Your ATM is safe, your banks are safe, there's enough cash in the financial system, and there is an infinite amount of cash at the Federal Reserve. We will do whatever we need to do to make sure that there's enough cash in the banking system.
Are you optimistic or pessimistic?
Overall, I'm optimistic. Having been at the front line of the 2008 financial crisis, and I saw how devastating that was, we did get through it. It was very painful for millions of Americans. We did get through it. We will get through this crisis.
All right, so thanks for checking out this week's Mining Payout. Stay tuned for next week's as well. And at the end of these Mining Payout videos, I'm going to have a new segment where I choose a random comment from my previous payout video. And this is this week's feature. And if you didn't want to be featured in my next week's Mining Payout video, just write a comment below. Okay, so hope you enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you enjoyed it, sub if you study see what's next. But of course, thanks for watching and always, happy mining. To live.